Next up is Boxfish.
My name is Axel, I'm from Boxfish Research. We're working out of Portland, New Zealand. We're three self-funded engineers. And we work in the $3 billion strong underwater unmanned vehicle industry. Our apprentice industry is a not new way of creating content underwater with robots, VR equipment, and AR equipment for markets such as education, filmmaking, security, defense, construction, and archaeology, for example. What we brought to the CES here is a 360 underwater camera that can go to 1,000 feet and an ROV that can go to 3,000 feet and can capture uncompressed 4K video to the surface that speeds up the workflow for our clients, and that's actually the focus of all our products. You make it easier to use and speed up the workflow at a quarter of the price of existing products. Thank you very much.
So you said it was a quarter of the price of existing products. What's an existing product?
Existing products is the ROV that's been used for these applications. They typically sell for around $200,000 to $2 million. It's slightly upper edge consumer.
So you're like $50,000?
$50,000.
So OpenRoth, I'm sure you're familiar with OpenRoth.
Yeah. Okay.
Like, is this a higher end product, more expensive, more professional, like more consumer? Like who buys this from?
That's true. OpenRoth, you can compare like electric bicycle to electric car. That's how you would use it. You often sell this to museums or production companies, science institutes, aquariums. They'll be kind of users for this application, but we have a lot of interest here from construction as well, which was new to us, and then defense, which is a market that's probably a little more difficult to get into. And there are the 360 camera, that is the same application, but a little bit cheaper, and also for enthusiasts like myself. I'm a cave diver and wreck diver, and I love to show caves and wrecks to people who do not want to go over there.
How hard is it to learn how to operate this?
It's like 30 seconds. It operates like any drone. So up, down, left, right, you know, you can angle it anywhere you want, and then just drive it like that. It's very, very easy. Self-stabilization, you know what you expect. And you can also drive it autonomously without a tether. So you program the path, and it just does a bottom 30, for example. It's good for counters and the defense application when you're looking for something that you drop.
Complex. How long does it take to get the parts of a big one?
So we worked for 3 years on this. The challenge was especially getting, because we wanted to have all the IP in-house, to go to the depth of 3,000 feet and operate for this with battery up to 6 hours. And so we built all the sensors, also the control system, the application that runs it, that's all in-house IP. And now we're in the process of finding a capital to go to market and bring this out big time. The camera is already available. It's available after the show. You can order it. It's $15,000. And so that's how we're going to fund the rest until we find capital to go faster.
Okay, so this is a production sample, prototype.
Yeah. We're using this for rental at the moment, so we have a booking next week, for example. We're shooting semiconductor sharks for modern dinosaurs, TV series, and that's a way of funding the development.
So you actually don't have any units out there?
That is the only unit, yeah.
Okay, so that's the only unit out there.
But the existing camera is ready, so we've got 10 units.
All right, thank you, Boxfish.